To speak, and please pay attention, otherwise last lesson we started and it didn't. Okay. Good evening, dear ladies. Baruch Hashem, we are before Pesach. Baruch Hashem, we are now slaves to cleaning the house from chametz. But the most important thing is that we'll clean our hearts from the chametz. And the only way to clean our hearts from the chametz is to work on our characteristics, to be a better human beings, to find the merit of each other, to be nice to each other. We were speaking in the before we started recording the lesson, and I would like to remind you, if you want Mashiach to come with mercy, we have to have mercy upon each other. And chas v'shalom, we shouldn't judge each other, because then it will come midaka neged midah, measure for measure. But if we don't, and we have false hatred among us, then Mashiach will come with Third World War, lo aleinu, and a lot of balagan. So if we truly want Mashiach with mercy, we need, and you'll tell me, yes, but I can do that and others don't, it starts with one person. So we'll start, each and every one of us, perach meyapet atzmo meyapet agan, a flower that makes itself pretty, the whole garden is pretty because of it. So let's bless Bezat Hashem. שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו אמן. שיגיע מבשר אליהו הנביא, אליהו תשבי, אליהו גלדי. במהרה משיח בנביא אליהו נביא זכור לטוב בעזרת השם. And I would like to tell you this, coming Shabbat בעזרת השם is Shabbat Rosh Chodesh Nisan. And the name, מה? Yes, ברוך השם, it's Shabbat, it's פרשת הזריעה, and this is Shabbat HaChodesh, you remember? That we had Shabbat Parah, this was the last Shabbat, and this is Shabbat, it's Shabbat Rosh Chodesh Nisan, it's also Shabbat HaChodesh, and it's Shabbat Parashat Tazriah. Isha ki Tazriah v'yalda Zachar. Dear ladies, the name of Hashem is exactly that it's written in the Siddur. It comes from the Pasuk, from Tehillim, chapter 97, Ismechu HaShamayim v'tagel Haaretz. And when Mashiach is here, Yismechu HaShamayim, heaven will be happy and also earth will be happy. Yismechu HaShamayim v'tagel Haaretz. Yismechu v'tagel, both of them are words of happiness. So when Mashiach is here, Be'ezrat Hashem, it will be heaven on earth and also heaven will be happy with everything that is happening here on earth. There will be one, Be'ezrat Hashem. So this, the name of Hashem, when we say Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh, Shabbat Yisrael v'Rashei Chodashim, dear ladies, we mention, we just look at the name that is written in the Siddur, okay? And then the name of Tshuva is the name, Heyeh Asher Heyeh, that's the name of Tshuva. So it's exactly because this is full name of mercy. This is the name of Hashem for the month of Nisan. This is the name of Geula, the name of mercy, Bezrat Hashem. I would like to remind you that we spoke from the Garach Mivolozhin, which was the student of the Gaon Mevilna, Zchutam Tagen Aleinu. That it's a big sgula. If a person has problems, and listen very carefully, problems or he doesn't have any problem, he's very happy in this world, to understand that everything comes from Hashem. And even though we are in a situation, Hashem is with us. Hashem is holding us in His hand, ki malachav etzabelach, because He puts His angels to hold us and to go with us through the situation that we are in. And it doesn't matter how harsh the situation is. It doesn't matter on the scale of harshness, if it's a small at the beginning of the scale or at the end of the scale, Hashem is with us. Just like He was with us when we went out of Egypt. It's the same thing. Hashem is with us in every moment, in everything that we do. And if we have a true belief, true emunah, and true confidence in Hashem, then everything will become mercy. Everything becomes mercy. There's nothing of judgment, that non-judgment stays. Why? Because when I believe in Hashem and I know that this situation that I'm in it, it's from Hashem, then Hashem helps me to go through it, and that everything will become mercy. All the judgment will be softened on the right side, not on the left side. That's why we say, Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, which means, it means that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Zechutot Hagaon, says, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem is the name of judgment, Zedin. And so Hashem is the name of mercy, sorry. And Elokeinu is the name of judgment. Hashem is the name of mercy, and Elokeinu is the name of judgment. And it says, Shema Yisrael, listen Israel, Hashem Elokeinu, the name of Hashem of mercy, and the name of Hashem of judgment, Hashem Echad, they are all mercy. They are one. In the judgment, there is more mercy than in the mercy itself by its own. Betoch ha-din yesh yoter chesed ma'asher yesh b'chesed b'fnei atzmo. Why? Because the judgment, okay, because the judgment, dear ladies, is in order that we will cleanse our sins. In order that we will have and will go back under the throne of Hashem, we'll have a schut, a merit in the true world. So, dear ladies, this is Shema Yisrael. Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, means that the name of mercy and the name of judgment of Hashem is one. And we can see that the name of judgment starts with Kel. You see the letter Aleph and the letter Lamed, which means Chesed Kel Kol Hayom. The mercy of Hashem is the whole day. So in the judgment, there's more mercy than in the mercy itself. But both of them together are all mercy. Hashem Echad. And I told you that Shema Yisrael starts with a Shin. Echad, one. Ends with a Dalet, which is shed like a demon. And when we say Shema Yisrael, we take off the four klipot, four demons that are the heads of other demons, of other destructive angels. And they are, dear ladies, we go to the Zohar, Kadosh Tikkuni HaZohar, and we go to chapter 78 in Tehillim, and over there, I'm just reminding you so we can continue. It says, "V'hu rachum yachaper avon," and he is merciful, and he's going to atone us for any sin. "V'lo yashchit," and he won't destroy. "V'irba lashiva po," and he won't be angry. "V'lo yair kol chamato," and he won't awaken all of his wrath. It speaks about Hashem when we don't listen to Hashem, and we don't do what Hashem wants us to do. So the Zohar HaKadosh says, there are four heads of destructive angels. And that one of them is Avon. You see, Yechaper Avon, it is parallel to the one that is called Avon. And Velo Yashchit, dear ladies, is Mashchit, destructive. That's what his name. Apo is Af. It's his anger. It's called the destructive angel of anger. And Velo Yerkol Chamato, Chamato Zecheima. This is the destructive angel of wrath. Those are the four destructive angels. I'm just reminding you, because we studied this in the first shiur. So when we say Shema Yisrael, we take them off of us. Because what is left from Shema, listen, is Mem and Ayin. And what is left of Echad, one, is Aleph and Chet. Mem is the initial of Mashchit. You see? It starts with a Mem. Ayin is Avon. Aleph is Af, anger, and Bechet Zecheima, which is wrath. So when we say Shema Yisrael, and we mean Shema Yisrael, we take all of this out of us, all of this klipot from us, all of these destructive angels.
That is so beautiful.
So we spoke thoroughly in the previous lessons about it. Now we're going to continue. It's written, we are in Chumash Vayikra, and we just and Parashat Vayikra, we already went with Zot HaTorah Le'ola, Le'mincha, Ve'lechatat, Ve'le'asham. These are the sacrifices when we give Le'ola, when we have thoughts that were not good, so we give Le'ola, and then it's burned totally, because like the thoughts were not good, all of these thoughts will be eliminated from us and taken away. ולמנחה ולחטאת ולאשם, all of these are also sacrifices when we sin to Hashem in different levels. So dear ladies, these are four, and each one of them is in order to take away one of the four destructive angels. Because Le'ola is parallel to Avon. It starts with Ayin for Avon. And then Le'mincha, it starts with a Lamed, it's for Mashchit, destructive. Lechatat, it's not with a chet cheima, raf. Ve'le'asham, af. You see, the destructive angel of af. So if we study Torah, we cause all of these destructive angels to go away from us. Because Zot HaTorah, how do we do that? If you remember, what is Zot? Dear ladies, the word Zot. Zot, dear ladies, Zayin is 7, Aleph is 1, Kaf is 400. Together it's 408. 408. And I'm reminding you, it's a Kol, Tzom, Vemamon. It's Kol means prayers, Tzom is fasting, Vemamon is tzedakah. Kol, Kuf is 100, Vav is 6, Lamed is 30, it's 136. Tzom, fast, Tzadik is 90, Vav is 6, Mem is 40, 136. Mamon, Mem is 40, another Mem is 40, Vav is 6, Nun is 50, 136, together it's 408. So, Zot HaTorah, when we study Torah, when we study the Torah, like we should, women at least once a week to go and listen to a Shur Torah, because it refreshes our soul and gives us energy and the power to continue to do exactly what Hashem wants us. It goes with us through the whole week. And then we come again to the shiur in order to study again. And then we come with this Shekhinah with us to go, the holy presence, dear ladies, the divine presence with us the whole week. So you see it over here. We see Zot, it means to repent to Hashem. And when we study Torah, we cause these four destructive angels, which are the head of other destructive angels, to be eliminated from us. Because it's in numerical value, it's parallel. Zot HaTorah, this is the Torah, to Avon, Mashchit, Chema, Ve'ah. Sin, destructive, those are the angels. Chema, which is wrath and anger. This is, together it's 1,024, and this together is 1,024 in numerical value. It's parallel to this. Now, dear ladies, I would like to go, because we are speaking in this Parashat HaShavua, we have mitzvat milah, dear ladies. We have circumcision. Yeah, it's just mamash connected. And we are before Pesach, so we're going to speak about the Agadah shel Pesach. Look, Baruch Hashem. Hashem loves us. So Parashat Tazria starts b'shah tova. Vaydaber Hashem el Moshe lemor. Hashem spoke to Moshe and told him, Daber el bnei Yisrael lemor. Speak to the children of Israel and tell them, Isha ki tazria ve'alda zachar. If a woman got pregnant and she gave birth to a baby boy, ve'tam'a shivat yamim, and she is not pure for 7 days, ki mei nidat votat itma, just like she has a period. So this is called tum'at leida, dear ladies, just like a period. Uveyom hashmini yimol psar olato, and on the 8th day, the child should be circumcised, just like Yitzchak Avinu, on the 8th day. Why? Because the child has to pass through Shabbat. Yoter misheshamru bnei Yisrael the Shabbat, the Shabbat shamra aleihem. More than the children of Israel kept the Shabbat protected the children of Israel. So the child has to go through a Shabbat. And then he's protected by the holiness. I will speak about Kedushat Shabbat. By the holiness of the Shabbat. And then Hashem protects him. And 8, you remember, because Shabbat is 7. 7 is nature, and 8 is above nature. 8 is against Ayin Hara, evil eye, because 8 is like an Ayin. It's above nature. So then on the 8th day, he is circumcised. And why? Because of the 4 klipot, the 4 destructive angels. Because, look, I wrote it here because so you can copy it and write it and show it to your husbands and to your sons, to everyone. Mitzvat milah, the mitzvah of circumcision. Why? Because it's spiritual. Not only it's healthy, but it's spiritual. That's the most important thing. Because ha'orla atzma, the orla atzma, I don't know how you say orla in English.
Orla, it's a skin.
The skin, Ken.
Foreskin.
No, it's foreskin. Foreskin. Okay. So, foreskin, I forgot the word. The foreskin itself is a parallel to the destructive angel of sin. Zaorla Ain, you see the Ain Orla and the Ain of Avon. You see it over here? The Orla is parallel to the destructive angel of So once they do the Brit Milah and the Avodah Atzma and they cause this destructive angel of Avon of sin not to influence the child, then La Orlah. The Orlah has three more layers. They are parallel to the three other destructive angels. Mashchit, destructive, Af, anger, Vecheima, which is wrath. That's why we do Brit Milah. Do you understand? It's so important. Not only the Milah, but the Priya at the end. You have to do Priya, dear ladies. And now I'm going to go to B'Seyata Nishma, to Moshe Rabbeinu. And we remember the story of Moshe Rabbeinu. Hashem spoke to Moshe Rabbeinu with a burning bush, and he told him, you have to go back to Egypt, and the people that wanted to kill you are dead. And they weren't dead. The Tanya Aviram were alive, but they became very poor, and a poor person is considered dead because it doesn't have any influence anymore. So he told him, now you can go. And Moshe Rabbeinu, I'll just open it. And Moshe Rabbeinu takes his wife, and they're on the journey back to Egypt. And it says, dear ladies, Vayi baderech, and on the way, Bamalon vayifgeshehu Hashem vayivakesh hamito. So on the way, he's with his two children, Gershom ve'Elazar, dear ladies, two children. Just a minute, I want to open also Bereshit Rabbah. I didn't bring all the books because I cannot handle taking everything, but I made copies so I can give it to you. So it says that on the way, a kind angel, comes to kill Moshe Rabbeinu. And Rashi says, Vayavakesh lamito. LeMoshe, to kill Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu that went on a mission from Hashem, that just spoke with Hashem in the burning bush, and is going to Egypt now to save the children of Israel, to be the Mashiach. And it says by Rashi, Lefi shelo mal et Eliezer, because he didn't circumcise his son Eliezer. Ve'al shenitrashel ne'enash onesh mita, because he didn't do it quickly, he was deservable of death. And this is very weird, because if you don't circumcise your son, it doesn't threaten in the mitzvot, in the Jewish commandments, that you deserve death for this. But the more you are holier, the more you are closer to Hashem, Hashem looks at you with a magnifying glass. Do you understand? So let's continue. So Moshe is going. Ketuv kacha. Tanya amar Rabbi Yosei, Rabbi Yosei, chas v'chalila on etrashal. Rabbi Yosei said, chas v'chalila, Moshe Rabbeinu did not do what, did not mean not to circumcise his son and did not prevent it on purpose. Ela amar, but Moshe Rabbeinu was thinking, emol ve'etzel aderech, if I will circumcise my son and I will go out to travel, he says, sakanai latinok at shlusha yamim. 3 days, it's a danger of death, lo alenu. The baby has, even there's a special halachot for babies that are circumcised during, and even on Friday, and they're passing through Shabbat, you're allowed to wash them. There's special halachot for this, because there are 3 days of danger for the tinok, for the baby, after circumcising. So he says, emol ve'eshesh shlusha yamim, maybe I should stay with Yitro, I will circumcise him, and then I'll wait 3 days, and there I will go. HaKadosh Baruch Hu tzivani, lech shuv Mitzrayim. Says, but I can't, because Hashem ordered me to go back to Egypt, and I have to listen to his order now, his commandment now. U'mipnei ma ne'enash mita. Why? So these are very logical, because Moshe Rabbeinu said, I can't, if I'll stay and I'll circumcise him, I have to stay 3 days. But Hashem commanded me to go back to Egypt. So he said, and if I, so he says, I will go to the hotel and then I will circumcise him. But why was he punished? Because before he circumcises him, it says, Lefi shenitasek b'malon tchila. First he went, you know, to the owner of the hotel to do everything, to pay him and to speak with him before he circumcised his son. So because of this, he was ordered deaf. So what happened? It says, Avaya malach ne'esak kemin nachash. The angel became like a snake. Uvol'o merosho ve'ad yerechav. And he swallowed him from et Moshe Rabbeinu, from his head to his hips. Then he vomited him out, and then he swallowed him from his legs, ad otomakom, from his legs to the place of the circumcision. Now Tzipora is standing over there, and she sees what's happened, and she understands that her husband can die. Listen, ככה כתוב, ותיגה לרגליו, which means that he sees that the angel swallows him from the head to the hips, and then from the legs to the place of the circumcision. She understands that she has to circumcise her son. She understands this. And it's written, dear ladies, כל זכויות שעשה משה רבינו, it's written in Shmot Rabbah, Chet Chet, it's written, כל הזכויות שעשה משה רבינו, all of the mitzvot and all of the merit that Moshe Rabbeinu did, לא עמדו לו. It didn't stand for him כשנתרשל מן המילה. When he didn't circumcise his sons, and he waited with this. חס ושלום שנתרשל משה רבינו מן המילה. חס ושלום that we will say that Moshe Rabbeinu was not righteous in the ways that he did the commandments of Hashem. Ella, again, he says, if I will circumcise him and he will go out, would start the journey, there's a big danger for the baby, chas v'shalom, to pass away. Then he says, I will first go to the hotel and over there I'll circumcise him because I've already started the command. Shem told me, go. I already started going to Egypt. He says, and that's why, because he was standing and speaking to the owner of the hotel, two angels came. And the angels were af bechema, anger and wrath. Both of them came, and they became like one snake. And they were swallowing Moshe Rabbeinu from the head to the hips, throwing him out, and then from the legs to the place of the circumcision. They became like one, the two angels. I'm telling you that it's important to understand why I'm saying this. The two angels. And this, it says like this, Ba'u af b'cheima malachei chabala, destructive angels, ve'balu, and they swallowed him. And then, ve'lo shiru menu el haraglav, and they didn't leave anything, just the place of the circumcision. And Tzipora saw this, is why, ba'tikach Tzipora tzur, and Tzipora took a stone that is called tzur, ותכרות את עולת בנה, and she made a circumcision to her son. Because he couldn't, the angels were swallowing him in order to kill him. And she did this, and she did priya, dear ladies, and this is how she, and this is how ויערף ממנו, and this is how the angels left him, and she saved the life of Moshe Rabbeinu. באותה שעה ביקש Moshe Rabbeinu להורגן. Moshe Rabbeinu wanted to kill the two angels. Listen, Moshe Rabbeinu wanted at that moment. כתוב באותה שעה, ביקש Moshe Rabbeinu להורגן, the two angels, ויש אומרים לכם הרגו. And they say that he killed this angel of wrath. I told you there are four klipot, נכון? We say in Shema Yisrael in order to take them away from us. Mashchit, which is destructive angel, the angel of sin, the angel of anger, and the angel of chema. We have mem, ayin, aleph, v'chet. And, dear ladies, when we say enod milvado, and we spoke about it, we mention only three of them. Af, the aleph is for af, ayin is for avon, and mem ze mashchit. It's anger, you see, avon is sin, anger, avon is sin, and then mashchit, destructive. So where is wrath? Where is this? So it's written in the prophet Yeshayahu. I wrote it here? I think yes. Oh, it's written in the prophet Yeshayahu, chapter 27, verse 4. Chema enli. Moshe Rabbeinu killed the angel of chema, the angel of wrath. When we say Enod Milvado, we prevent these three angels to touch us. Enod Milvado. And these destructive angels, And you remember that Rabbi Hanina speaks about it. Just I'll find the place. Wait. You need to have. He didn't have the 50th gate of purity. He had only 49. But dear ladies, and he didn't have permission from Hashem. He has to have a permission from Hashem. And dear ladies, it says. It says by Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Lama nikra shman kshafim? Why the sorcery called sorcery? Umetaretz et haGemara, dear ladies. It's written ki mashemakhishin pamaya shel mala, that they cause contradiction in what happens in, because we think that it's true. We see that black magic influences us, so we think it's true. But dear ladies, Rabbi Hanina understood that sorcery and black magic cannot influence us unless Hashem wants it to influence us. But if we, the more we become holier, dear ladies, the more we study Torah, the more that our life is in the way of Hashem, and the more we listen to Hashem, this prevents sorcery, black magic, every bad thing to touch us. Do you understand this? So the nations that the sorcery come from are three nations. It's three nations. We look at En Od Milvado. There's none besides Hashem. So we have, this is, I told you, Af, the angel, there's Amalachim. Af, which is anger. Ayin is Avon, which is a sin, and then Mashchit, which is destructive. And this is parallel to Edom. Aleph is for Edom. Ayin is for Ammon, the nation of Ammon. The Mem is Moab, the nation of Moab. You remember Moab? You remember that they called Bilam in order to curse our enemies? You remember? Chumash Bamidbar, Parashat Balak, dear ladies. These are the three nations, Edom, Ammon, Moab. So how does Hashem protect us from this? So let's start, let's continue. Let's go to Yaakov Avinu. It says, Hashem tells Yaakov Avinu, don't worry, go to Egypt. Because this is what Hashem told Avraham Avinu, Bebrit Ben Amitarim. You remember he told Avraham Avinu, your children are going to be slaves for 400 years to a nation that they don't know. So he tells Yaakov Avinu, please go. You know that Yosef is in Egypt now. Please go to Yosef. So what tells him Hashem? Hashem says to Yaakov Avinu, don't worry. Anochi ered imcha Mitzrayma. I am going to go with you to Egypt. Which means the divine presence is going to be with you in Egypt. And I'm going to take all sorcery away from you. How do we know? Because Hashem says, En od milvado. Look, En od milvado. Anochi ered imcha Mitzrayma. I will go with you to Egypt and I will prevent them from doing sorcery to my children. With one of my names, from the 72 names, En od milvado. There's none besides Hashem. And then we go to the Haggadah Shel Pesach. We say in the Haggadah, Eilu Eser Makot Shehevi HaKadosh Baruch Hu Al HaMitzrim BeMitzrayim. These are the 10 plagues that Hashem brought on the Egyptians in Egypt. Eilu Eser Makot Ein Od Milvado. HaKadosh Baruch Hu Gadol. Yes. And this is from Ora Shel Torah, from Rabbi Pinchas Friedman, B'Siyata Dishmaya. And it was quoted by Arav Moshe Mizrahi Bebnei Tzion. So look at Haggadah Shel Pesach, and we have a mash before Pesach. Eilu Eser Makot Shehevi HaKadosh Baruch Hu Al HaMitzrim BeMitzrayim. These are the 10 plagues that Hashem brought on the Egyptians in Egypt. We see that the initials is En Od Milvado. There's none besides Hashem. And we continue. Let's go to Shabbat. The holiness of Shabbat. I just told you about Brit Milan, the circumcision. Vayechal Elokim b'yom ha'shvi, and Hashem finished on the seventh day melachto asher asa, all of his, the work of creating the world that he started in the 6 days. So he finished it on the seventh day. Vayishbat b'yom ha'shvi, and Hashem was resting on the seventh day. Mikol melachto asher asa, from all of the work that he did on the 6 days when he created the world. Melachto, the work, asher asa, melachto asher asa, ein od milvado. You see, ein od milvado? That's why it's so important that we say it, Vayechal Elokim b'yom ha'shvi, on Friday night, on the Kiddush, yeah. To say it with your husbands. Even to look in the Siddur and to say it. And lechaven, that nothing bad can touch us in Klal Yisrael. No sorcery, nothing bad, no destructive angels. Ein od milvado, melachto asher asa, all of the work that Hashem did. You see it over here? Vayechal Elokim b'yom ha'shvi, and Hashem completed on the seventh day melachto asher asa, all of the work that he did on the 6 days. Vayishbot b'yom ha'shvi, and he rested on the seventh day. Mikol melachto asher asa, from all of the work that he did, and the initials of melachto asher asa, the work that he did, is Mem for the angel of Mashchit, destructive, Aleph for the angels of angel of anger, and Ayin, the angel of Avon, of sin, and it's paralleled it against Mem, the kingdom of Moab, the children of Moab. Aleph is the children of Edom, that we are in the exile of Edom now for 2,000 years almost. And Ayin for the children of Moab. Who are the children of Edom? This is Esav, Amalek. Esav, Amalek, you remember, feed me from this red the soup. Marak Hadashim, he told Yaakov Avinu when he came from hunting. And who is the grandchild of Esav? Amalek. Who is Amon and Moab? They are the children of Lot. Lot is the nephew of Abraham Avinu, Achyan shel Abraham Avinu. Abraham Avinu. You remember what happened when the angels came to take him out of Sodom and Gomorrah? They took Lot and his wife and his children, and then his daughters thought that there's no people in the world anymore. So they gave him wine to drink, and the oldest went to, and was intimate with him, and the next night the youngest was. And we have Ammon ben Moab. Those are the people of Ammon ben Moab. From them, there's Ammon ben Moab. And also, I told you, Zelumat Zebara Elokim, that Hashem created this parallel to this, the good and the not good parallel to each other. So from Moab, we have Mashiach, because Ruth was Moabiah. And from her generations, is Mashiach ben David. So look how everything is connected. So even Kedushat HaShabbat, if you keep Shabbat like you are supposed to keep it, by halacha, dear ladies, no sorcery can touch you. Because the Shabbat eliminates all of the sorcery that are during the weekdays. And it protects you. Yoter mishashem ruam Yisrael ta Shabbat, HaShabbat shamra alehem. More than the children of Israel kept the Shabbat, the Shabbat was keeping them safe. Yeah. You understand? By just saying Shabbat. Lichvot Shabbat Kodesh. Everything that we eat, everything that we buy, Shabbat. So let's continue for Yosef HaTzadik, dear ladies. It's written, you remember the children of Israel, now we are going through the Yetziat Mitzrayim. Hashem tells them that they're going to go just take jewelry and from the Egyptians and clothing. And then Moshe Rabbeinu is occupied with finding the bones of Yosef HaTzadik. So now we go, dear ladies, to... I need the glasses. We are going to Midrash Rabbah, dear ladies, Perek Chaf, Parashat Beshalach. And over there it's written Kaf. Vayikach Moshe Tatzmot Yosef. And Moshe is not taking any jewelry and is not occupied with taking, like Hashem told him to tell the children of Israel, but he's occupied of finding the bones of Yosef HaTzadik. עליו הכתוב אומר, חכם לב ייקח מצוות. It's written in Mishlei, King Solomon says that a wise person will take mitzvot. שכל ישראל היו עסוקים בחסד וזהב, ומשה היה עסוק בעצמות יוסף. All of the children of Israel are engaged in gathering כסף וזהב, money and gold, the silver and gold, and Moshe Rabbeinu was occupied with finding the bones of Yosef. And it's written, אמר הקדוש ברוך הוא למשה, עליך נתקיים חכב לב ייקח מצוות. Hashem said, told to Moshe, it is true about you that a wise person will take mitzvot. יוסף היה חייב להביא לקוברו מפני שהוא בנו. יוסף needed to bury his father because he was his son. And Moshe Rabbeinu was not the son of Yosef. He says, Hashem tells him, ואתה לא בנו, you're not his son, ולא בן בנו, and you're not the son of his son. Because you remember that Yosef HaTzadik is one of the sons of Rachel. And you know that Moshe Rabbeinu is one of the sons of Leah, because he comes from Shevet Levi. And Yosef HaTzadik comes from Shevet, he's Yosef, the tribe of Yosef. ולא בנו, ולא היית חייב לעסוק בו, and it is, you want obligated to deal with this. וקברת אותו, and you did occupy yourself with finding his bones. וכן אני שאיני חייב לבריאה, he says, because you did this, and you were occupied in finding the bones of Yosef and taking them out of Egypt, and to see that they will come to the land of Israel, that they will be buried over there, dear ladies, because of that, he says, and you weren't obligated to do this, says HaKadosh Baruch Hu to Moshe Rabbeinu, he says, וכן אני שאיני חייב לבריאה, I don't know, oh, Hashem says, any human being, anything, says Hashem, אני מטפל בך ואני אקברך, which means I will take care of you and I will bury you, personally, Hashem on his own, Hashem himself will deal with Moshe Rabbeinu.
But why he did not bury him in Israel?
But he did, they did, because they took out the bones and the bones went with Aron HaKodesh and then they went into Israel, the children of Israel, Moshe Rabbeinu didn't, he would pass away in the desert. But the children of Israel took the bones of Yosef into the land of Israel.
No, I just think about Moshe.
Yeah. Why was it Moshe Rabbeinu buried in Israel?
We spoke about it. I won't go into it. But Moshe Rabbeinu, part of it, he is supposed to help the children of Israel. All the men that passed away in the desert, he will bring them, all of them back. His zchut will bring them back into the land of Israel. Moshiach is here. And furthermore, he's buried in front of Bet Beor. I'm just giving you, yes. It's like a captain that goes down with a ship. So, dear ladies, Bet Beor, the idol ship of Peor, you remember it, I spoke with you about it. I don't want to go into it now, but I'll just give you a small thing. It's an idol ship that people do their waste over there. And when this rises up, Moshe Rabbeinu rises up too and he goes down and cannot prosecute the children of Israel. So Moshe Rabbeinu in his death helped the children of Israel even furthermore than on his when he was alive. So dear ladies, and it's written בחומש דברים ויקבור אותו בגיא, and Hashem himself, the divine presence, buried Moshe Rabbeinu בגיא. ומניין היה משה יודע איכן היה יוסף קבור? And how did Moshe Rabbeinu know where Yosef is buried? יש אומרים, they say, במדרש רבה it says, that Serach בת אשר, Serach, the daughter of Asher, and you remember that she went to heaven alive, yeah, with her body, הראה אותו והיה קבור בנילוס. She told him where he's buried in the Nile, in the river Nile, dear ladies. מה עשה משה? What did Moshe Rabbeinu? It's very hard because I need to read with the glasses, but I need to look without the glasses. מה עשה משה? So, what did Moshe Rabbeinu do? ויש אומרים, just a minute, and there's some that say that he was buried כדרך המלכים, like all of the kings that were buried in Egypt, and there were dogs that were made out of gold. ועשו מצרים כלבים של זהב, which means gold dogs, בכשפים with magic, with sorcery, like we speak, אין עוד מלבדו, שאם יבוא אדם לשם, יהיו נופחים, if a person will come and try to take the bones of Yosef, because they knew that it gives them הצלחה, big blessing, וקולן הולך בכל ארץ מצרים, מהלך 40 יום. That all of the Egyptians will hear, and then they cannot take the bones of Yosef. And it says, dear ladies, that Moshe started shouting, Yosef, Yosef, הגיע השעה שאמרת, the time that you said came, he says, פקוד יפקוד אלוקים אתכם, which means Hashem will be revealed to you, and he will, you will repent you out of Egypt and save you. מיד נתנדנד אהרון. And immediately when the bones of Yosef heard what the shout of Moshe Rabbeinu, the coffin that he was in started shaking. ונטלו משה, and went out of the Nile, and Moshe Rabbeinu took him. שנאמר, ויקח משה את עצמות יוסף. And dear ladies, it says, and then he took him out, and Moshe Rabbeinu took it, and the coffin with the bones of Moshe Rabbeinu, of Yosef HaTzadik, was with the children of Israel 40 years in the desert, parallel to the ark, with the tablets inside it. The tablets, the first one that were broken, and the second one that were inside it. Do you understand how Moshe was tzaddik? Why Yosef HaTzadik was tzaddik? Why? Because we can see that he kept the milah. He guarded himself, the circumcision, he kept his milah, and he didn't go and wasn't intimate with any woman except for his wife. Because when a man does not keep his milah, and he has sperm that is wasted in vain, dear ladies, then all of the four destructive angels are upon him. All of them, dear ladies. Avon, which is a sin, mashchit, dear ladies, that is destructive, af, which is anger, and then chayma, which is wrath, all of the four destructive angels are around him. This is Gama Brit. So let's look, Yosef HaTzadik and Moshe Rabbeinu. Vayikach Moshe et atzmot Yosef, and Moshe takes the bones of Yosef, imo with him, ki hashbea ishbea, because Yosef made the children of Israel vow and promise, et bnei Yisrael emo, pakod yifkod etchem ve'eletem et atzmotai, mize etchem, and you will, v'siyat elishmea, take my bones with you. And over here he gave them the name of Hashem, En Od Milvado. Inside, in order that they will know, in order that no sorcery can control the children of Israel while they're going out of Egypt. Because you remember, there are 10 gates in Egypt, and there are sorcery on each gate and different animals on each gate. For example, from the gate of dogs, when if a slave would go out, the dogs will start barking and they will bring the slave back into Egypt. So you couldn't go out of Egypt. So because of this, you see that even Hashem takes Elu Esar Makor, these are the 10 plagues, because inside it, the initials are Ein Od Milvado, Aleph Ayin Mem. So you see, even in the promise that he made in promise, he gave them Ein Od Milvado. He gave them one of the 72 names of Hashem in order to prevent, to eliminate the influence of sorcery on the children of Israel so they can go out of Egypt. We are continuing, dear ladies, ועלינו לשבח. We say עלינו לשבח. 3 times a day. נכון? We need to praise the name of Hashem. And this is also considered that Yeshua is the one that said עלינו לשבח first. So it says, לפניך השם אלוקינו, in front of you השם אלוקינו, יחרו ויפולו, everybody will bow to you. ולכבוד שמך, and the honor of your name, יקר יתננתנו, which means honor they will give you. ויקבלו כולם את עול מלכותיך, and everybody at the end of the days will accept you, Hashem, as the one king in the world, one God in the world. And with this, when we say this, now you'll never forget עלינו לשבח, look at עול מלכותיך, אין עוד מלבדו, that they will accept your kingdom upon you, upon them, not only the Jewish people, but all of the nations at the end of days. Isn't that beautiful? I love you, Hashem, and I love you too. I love all of you.
Can you repeat the lesson?
Okay, pay attention. When we say, Aleinu Leshabeach, dear ladies, We say Lefanecha Hashem Elokeinu, in front of you Hashem Elokeinu. Again, Hashem is the name of mercy and Elokeinu is the name of judgment. Hashem Shem Chesed veElokeinu Shem Din. And you remember, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says, Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. Hashem is the name of mercy and Elokeinu is the name of judgment. But both of them, Hashem Echad, both of them are mercy. One. So it says, יכרעו ויפולו ולכבוד שמך יקר איתנו. Everybody's going to bow to you. And everybody will have honor to your name. And ויקבלו כולם, and all of the human beings, all the nations, not only the children of Israel, all of the universe, כולם יקבלו כולם, all of them are going to accept upon themselves את עול מלכותך, your kingdom. And your kingdom, et ol malchutecha, the initials is ein od milvado, which means that there will be no influence anymore to the kingdom of Edom, which is a Saben Amalek, the kingdom of Moab, and the kingdom of Ammon, which comes from Lot, dear ladies. So I would like to tell you, shevesiata dishmaya, ein od milvado, I would like to bless all of us, Besiyata Dishmaya. May Hashem bless us all that Mashiach Tzidken will be here now, Bezat Hashem. And we have the zchut to see Eliyahu Navi Zachur Latov. Lo'olam miparad adam mechaberu bidbar halacha yachid barabim halacha kerabim. Wait a minute. I would like